layers of intestine, please write down in your chat box, right? जो जो बेटा मैं क्वेश्चन पूछती जाऊंगी आप प्लीज उसका आंसर चैट बॉक्स में लिख देना है. दिस वुड बी अ इंटरैक्टिव सेशन, राइट? दिस इज नॉट अ लेक्चर, दिस इज योर ट्यूटोरियल. सो व्हाट आर द थ्री, व्हाट आर द फोर लाइनिंग्स ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन? देयर आर फोर लाइनिंग्स ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन, दैट इज okay, there are four linings of intestine, that is mucosa, submucosa, muscularis mucosa and serosa. Because we are today we are learning about the intestinal tumors, so we should know about the tumors, that what are the tumors and what are the good. Very good. Has given me an answer. Very good, beta. So there are four layers we have discussed, that is mucosa, submucosa, muscularis propria, and serosa. And second thing, anybody know about what is tumor or what is neoplasia? Kindly write down your answer, beta. What is neoplasia? It means that this is a new growth, right? Neoplasia means new growth, and it is also called the tumor. अच्छा जी, व्हाट आर द ट्यूमर्स? एक्चुअली द ट्यूमर्स हैव टू बेसिक कंपोनेंट्स. इफ द वन सेल और इफ यू हैव अ सैंपल एंड यू आर सस्पेक्टिंग दैट मे बी इट इज ट्यूमर, ठीक है, सो देन यू शुड नो अबाउट द टू मेजर कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द ट्यूमर. इफ देयर इज अ टू मेजर कंपोनेंट ऑफ द ट्यूमर, देन यू विल से ओके दिस इज अ ट्यूमर, ठीक है. अच्छा, व्हाट आर द दोस टू बेसिक कंपोनेंट्स? Neoplastic cells that constitute the tumor parenchyma and the reactive stroma made up of the connective tissue, blood vessels and variable number of the cells. Okay, so what are the variable number of cells? We all know there is a cells of the immune systems, right? Adaptive immune systems and innate immune systems. These cells are also present in the tumors, right? Okay. Then we also know about that the tumor is the tumor. Now come on the classification of the tumor. So there are two major classification. क्या होती है? Benign and the malignant tumors. ठीक है. अच्छा, benign क्या होता है? When its gross and microscopic appearance are relatively innocent. It means it is localized and will not spread to the other side. Right? While the malignant tumors are those tumors which have derived, as we all know, the malignancy or the carcinoma or the cancer is derived from the word crab. So the crab tends to adhere any part of the body, we all know. Similar like that, the carcinoma or malignancy can invade and destroy adjacent structures and spread to the different sites. Then there is another type of tumor, that is mixed tumor. In most benign and malignant neoplasms of the parenchymal cells, these are closely resembled to one another. Okay, that's why it is called the malignant, mixed tumor, right? Are you getting better? This is all basic, okay? Okay, now we will, before I will proceed towards the classification, okay, now come on the classification of the tumors of the small and the large intestine. I think in the morning you have taken the lecture of tumors of small and large intestine by Dr. Dupna. So there are two major classification, non-neoplastic and neoplastic. Acha, jo polyps hote hain beta, there are two types of polyps. Either it is neoplastic or either they are non-neoplastic. Acha, non-neoplastic polyps include hyperplastic polyps, hematomatous polyps, juvenile polyps, huge Jagger polyps, inflammatory polyps and the lymphoid polyps, right? While the neoplastic, if we talk about the neoplastic lesions, the neoplastic epithelial lesions, then there is benign tumors hote hain, then adenoma or adenomatous polyps hote hain, theek hai? So, yahan aap logo ne dekha ki jo adenomatous polyp hai, this is the neoplastic polyp, theek hai? Then malignant polyps, malignant lesions ho gaye, malignant tumors ho gaye, then adenocarcinoma, carcinoid tumors, squamous cell carcinoma of the anus, मेलिग्नेंट मेलानोमा, फिर उसके बाद अच्छा ये सारे दीज आर ऑल अंडर द हेडिंग ऑफ द एपिथेलियल लीजन्स, ठीक है। अच्छा जो मेसेनकाइमल लीजन्स भी होते हैं जिसमें गिस्ट आ जाता है, दैट इज गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टिनल स्टोमा ट्यूमर्स आता है, उसके बाद लिम्फोमास आ जाते हैं एंड सर्टेन मेटास्टेटिक, ठीक है। ओके नाउ वी विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन ऑफ ईच ऑफ द पॉलिप्स, ठीक है। अच्छा पॉलिप्स, व्हाट आर पॉलिप्स, वी शुड नो अबाउट व्हाट आर पॉलिप्स, ठीक है। इफ यू हैव एनी आइडिया प्लीज राइट डाउन इन योर चैट बॉक्स व्हाट इज पॉलिप्स। ओके जी, पॉलिप्स आर द स्मॉल एलिवेशन ऑफ द म्यूकोसा, देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ द पॉलिप्स, सेसाइड दैट इज दे ग्रो फ्लैट ऑन द टिश्यूज, ठीक है। दे अटैच डायरेक्टली टू द बेस, इट मींस इट हैज नो स्टॉक, ठीक है, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ सेसाइड। अदर वन इज द पेटेंकुलेटेड पॉलिप, पेटेंकुलेटेड मींस इट हैज अ स्टॉक एंड देन अबव द स्टॉक देयर इज द ग्रोथ, ठीक है, that which is called as the polyp, ठीक है, so this is a pedunculated polyp हो गया। Okay, now we will discuss first the hyperplastic polyp. These are benign epithelial proliferations and mostly occur in the 6th and the 7th decade, and the cause is unknown, but they are thought to be the result from the decreased epithelial cell turnover. As we all know, there is a continuous cell turnover on our body of the different lining of epithelial linings, ठीक है ना, we all know about it, ठीक है। If there is not continuous cell turnover, suppose if cell turnover is stopped, then what will happen? What will happen? Obviously, there is a excessive cell proliferation. Cell will continuously divide it, but they will not shed, ठीक है। Then what will happen? Ultimately, mass will be produced, ठीक है, mass will be produce and this type of mass, and you can say there is a pileup of the cells also, ठीक है, and these piling up of the cells are called the polyps, ठीक है। So the cause of the hyperplastic polyp is the delayed shedding of the cells leading to crowding that create the serrated surface architecture, that is the morphological hallmark of this. Okay, the small epithelial polyps usually less than 5 millimeter in diameter, they are single, but more often they are multiple. 50% are present in the rectum and the sigmoid colon. These lesions have no malignant potential, right? And histologically, they have well-formed glands and crypts that are lined by the neoplastic, absorptive, epithelial and the goblet cells. We all know that about the intestinal histology, histology of the intestine, that in the intestine there is a goblet cell, there is the absorptive cells, right, there is a crypt, there are glands. So in case of hyperplastic polyp, there are crypts and the absorptive epithelial and goblet cells are formed. Here you can see the histology of the hyperplastic polyp. Polyp surface with irregular tufting with the epithelial surface. Here you can see you can't appreciate the epithelial lining, right? यहाँ पे देखो epithelial lining कितनी disrupt हुई है और उसमें क्या है कि more tufting, it means the more irregular cells आ गए हैं यहाँ पे, ठीक है। तो आप इसको you can't appreciate over here that where is epithelial lining, ठीक है। So there, this is the hyperplasia, that is there is a increase in the number of the cells, ठीक है। Similarly, tufting result from the epithelial overcrowding. Here you can see this is the epithelial overcrowding and this is the tufting. Okay, these are the tufting of the epithelial cells. But when we see the cross section of these cysts, then you can see there is the serrated or spot. What is the meaning of the serrated? Serrated means the sawtooth. Okay, this is the sawtooth. If you see the saw, it has this like appearance. ठीक है, somewhat disliked appearance, ठीक है। So this is a sawtooth like appearance or it is also called the serrated, ठीक है। Epithelial crowding हो गई है साथ में और apart from that there is a serrated structure, ठीक है, when the crypts are occurred, ठीक है। These are all crypts beta, ठीक है, these are all crypts and these are the goblet cells. And what is the function of goblet cells? Please write down in your chat box what is the function of goblet cells. Very good. It secretes the mucus. Very good, beta. Okay. Now come all the inflammatory polyps. There are various causes of the inflammation. We all know about the inflammation very well, है ना? कि there is a continuous injury, there is a continuous healing, ठीक है? This is a cycle. If there is a chronic cycle of injury and the healing, then it can cause the development of the inflammatory polyps, ठीक है? अच्छा, what types of injuries? It may be there is a fatty food, ठीक है? There may be a red meat, processed meat. And ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, and the patient can develop the polyp in these type of cases. Okay. Similarly, the patient will develop the symptoms like the bleeding, rectal bleeding, and abdominal pain. Okay. Patient will complain of the rectal bleeding. Due to the rectal bleeding, patient can develop the iron deficiency anemia. These are the symptoms. Okay. Then what will happen? During the defecation, what will happen if this polyp, because if this polyp is present in the rectum, then what will happen if this polyp is present in the rectum, it will entrap in the fecal stream during the defecation and it leads to the mucosal prolapse. So if the patient comes to you with the mucosal prolapse or rectal prolapse, so you should think about the inflammatory polyps, or you should think about the polyps. Okay. The distinctive histological features पे अगर हम लोग आ जाए तो क्या क्या हो सकते हैं? The typical inflammatory polyps include mixed, because as the name suggests, this is inflammation. So there is a mixed inflammatory infiltrates, erosions, epithelial hyperplasias together with the lamina propria, fibromuscular hyperplasia. ठीक है, in short, you can say there are mixed inflammatory infiltrates. Obviously, there will be a erosion. Obviously, the continuous injuries. What will happen? It will cause the erosion of the surface. Then epithelial hyperplasia as well, continuous multiplication of the cell. Okay. Then this is the three clinical types of the inflammatory polyp. And what are these? Rectal bleeding, mucus discharge, and the inflammatory lesion of the anterior rectal wall. If the patient has these two complaints along with those, the sign of inflammatory lesion on the anterior rectal wall, then think about the inflammatory polyp. Getting beta? Are you getting? Now come on the histology of the inflammatory polyps. As the name suggests, the inflammatory polyp, there are so many inflammatory cells over here. These are all inflammatory cells. What are the inflammatory cells? Neutrophils. So they are, okay? न्यूट्रोफिल्स होते हैं, लिम्फोसाइट्स, मैक्रोफेजेस, ठीक है? तो दीज आर ऑल इन्फ्लेमेटरी सेल्स. हियर यू कैन सी दीज आर द डायलेटेड ग्लैंड्स, ठीक है? दीज आर ऑल द डायलेटेड ग्लैंड्स एंड विद द सुपरफिशियल इरोजंस, द डायलेटेड ग्लैंड्स, प्रोलिफरेटिव एपिथेलियम, सुपरफिशियल इरोजंस एंड इन्फ्लेमेटरी इन्फिल्ट्रेट्स आर टिपिकल एंड द इन्फ्लेमेटरी पॉलिप. हाउएवर द स्मूथ मसल हाइपरप्लेजिया विद इन द लैमिना प्रोप्रिया, such as smooth muscle hyperplasia also. These are all beta smooth muscles. Okay? These red are smooth muscles. So if there is a smooth muscle hyperplasia, you should think about there is a mucosal prolapse, because in the lamina propria, what will happen? These are lamina propria. Okay? This is epithelial lining. This is lamina propria. In lamina propria, there is connective presence. Okay? You all know about it. So the smooth muscle cells, if present in the lamina propria, you should think about maybe a mucosal prolapse. Okay, and here you can see the epithelial hyperplasia. Here you can see how many cells are present over there. Okay? If you know or if you remember the normal histology of the intestine, then you can appreciate these histopathological conditions as well. Okay, so these are the epithelial hyperplasia. Now come on the hematopoietic spot. अच्छा, हेमेटोमेटस पॉलिप्स में क्या क्या आ जाता है? वी शुड नो अबाउट व्हाट इज हेमेटोमा. प्लीज राइट डाउन इन योर चैट बॉक्स व्हाट इज हेमेटोमा. बेटा व्हाट इज हेमेटोमा? No, this is not a accumulation of blood. No, hematoma, beta. This is not hematoma. Okay, hematoma. Yes, exactly. This is a mixed tissue. Very good. This is a mixed tissue. Collection of the disorganized cells. Very good. So, hematoma is the collection. This is a benign growth. ठीक है, made up of the abnormal mixture of cells. ठीक है, so this is the hematoma. Hematoma has two types, that is juvenile polyps हो सकते हैं, इसके अलावा okay. Hematomatous polyps are juvenile polyps and the Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. Now we will discuss about the juvenile polyps. अच्छा जी, juvenile polyps क्या होते हैं? Mostly occur sporadically, but it may occur as a genetically. अच्छा, what is meant by sporadically? It means it may be occasionally present. ठीक है, it is not related to the genetic features. ठीक है, it is not related to any genetic mutation. ठीक है, so there is a sporadic juvenile polyps. They are unisolitary lesions and may also be referred to as a retention polyp. Both juvenile polyps are located in the rectum and typically present with the rectal bleeding, and if its size is less than 3 cm in diameter. Achha, apart from the rectal bleeding, patient may have the complaint of the intussusception, patient may have the complaint of the intestinal obstruction. Right? Okay. It was previously thought that it is a developmental defect. ठीक है? But now it is appreciated as a germline mutation in the tumor suppressor gene or the proto-oncogene. So what is germline mutation and what is somatic mutation? Any idea? What is germline mutation? What is the difference between germline mutation beta? Please write down whatever you know. Any idea what is germline mutation? Very good. Germline mutation is at birth, and it means that the germline mutation is detectable variation within the germ cells. ठीक है, the name suggests this is a germ cells, so this is the germline mutation. ठीक है, it can be passed on the offspring. Example, there are several germline mutations like hereditary breast tumors, ovarian tumors, these are all comes under the heading of the germline tumors. Okay? Some of these syndromes are associated with malignancy, either within the polyp or other intestinal or extra-intestinal site. So it may be considered as a pre-malignant neoplastic lesions. Individual with the autosomal dominant, as I have already discussed, that there may be sporadic cases or there may be a genetic cases. ठीक है, sporadic को मैंने discuss कर लिया. अब individual with the autosomal dominant syndrome of the juvenile polyposis have from 3 to as many as 100 hematomatous polyps. ठीक है, the vast majority of the juvenile polyps occur in the children younger than 5 years of age. But they can present at older ages as well. Okay. Achha, apart from the rectal bleeding, I have discussed that the patient may have the polyp prolapse through the anal sphincter. Achha, what is the meaning of the prolapse? It means that there is a dislodgement. It will move outward. Similarly, जैसे rectal prolapse होता है ना, तो prolapse का क्या मतलब होता है कि कोई भी चीज move downward. ठीक है, prolapse. ठीक है, so similarly mucosal prolapse. Mucosal prolapse क्या होता है कि मतलब it invade or from the outside from मतलब from आपको मैं ये किस तरह से मतलब same place में से वो outside जो है वो move कर जाएगा. ठीक है, so it means the prolapse. ठीक है, so the rectal prolapse है, mucosal prolapse है, तो ये सब एक मतलब इसी को कहेंगे कि अगर ये अपनी place से हट जाएगा and move towards outside the body. ठीक है, so जैसे rectal prolapse की patient, when you will do your pediatric ward, so then you will see so many children come with a complaint of the rectal prolapse, and then we take their history. They say that this is the forceful defecation. Okay? They give the history of the forceful defecation. They give the history of the constipation. Okay? So in these patients, they are both prone to develop the prolapse. Okay? Okay, जी. Now come on the histology. अच्छा, mostly as we have discussed, there is a mutation. This is a germline mutation. So mutation in the SMAD4, BMP, SMAD4, BMPRIAT3 beta signaling pathway gene. ठीक है. So these are the mutation. Actually, what will happen? The TGF beta signaling pathway is involved in many cellular processes. ठीक है. We all know about it. Like growth, cell proliferation, cell and apoptosis. Obviously, obviously, what will happen if there is a mutation in this signaling pathway, in this signaling molecule, in this signaling pathway, what will happen? There is a T2 receptor. Type 2 receptors is bind to the TGF beta superfamily, which recruits and phosphorylate the type 1 receptor. Type 1 receptor then phosphorylate the receptors, which regulate the this gene, SMAD4 gene. ठीक है. So where it acts as a transcription factor. ठीक है. And then it participates in the regulation of the gene expression. Obviously, what will happen when there is a mutation in the gene SMAD4, BMPRI1, or in TGF beta? Then what will happen? There is an abrupt growth. There is a dysregulation of the gene expression. And there is no control on the apoptosis. There is no apoptosis. Then what will happen? Obviously, polyp can develop. Okay? Okay. They are typically pedunculated. As I have discussed, there are two types of polyps. Sessile and pedunculated. Juvenile polyps are pedunculated. It means it has a stalk. Okay? They are typically pedunculated. Smooth surface, reddish brown appearance. Okay? Smooth surface, reddish regions hote hain ye. With characteristic cystic appearance. Okay? These are all cysts. These are all cysts which is filled with the mucin and the inflammatory debris. Okay? So these are all the cysts which is filled with the mucin and inflammatory debris. Now come on the Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. This is the rare autosomal dominant syndrome present at the median age of 11 years. Multiple GI hematomatous polyps and mucocutaneous hyperplasia usually presents with multiple GI hematomatous polyps. Okay? And patient also complain with the mucocutaneous hyperpigmentation. Achha, what type of hyperpigmentation are these? Dark blue to brown macules on the lips, on the nostril, on the buccal mucosa, palmar surfaces of the hand, genitalia, and the perianal region. It is mostly resembled with the freckles. But obviously, we all know freckles are not present on the buccal mucosa. Okay? So, if it is present on the buccal mucosa, so you should think about the Peutz-Jeghers polyps syndrome. Second thing is that it has an increased risk of several malignancies. And increased risk of, that's why the repeated surveillance is recommended. That is, that should be if there is a family history of Peutz-Jeghers polyps, then there should be increased surveillance of these patients, that is beginning at birth. ठीक है, हम लोग को at birth ही जो है वो surveillance start कर देनी होती है. अब कैसे कि beginning at birth पे हम लोग क्या क्या देखेंगे? For sex spot tumor, क्योंकि multiple malignancies हो सकती है metas में. ठीक है, multiple GI hematomatous polyp है ना, ये polyp कहीं भी develop हो सकता है. ठीक है, तो increased risk of several malignancies भी होती है. तो हमें at birth हम किसके लिए surveillance करेंगे? For the sex spot tumors of the testes. फिर लेट चाइल्डहुड में फॉर द गैस्ट्रिक एंड स्मॉल इंटेस्टिनल कैंसर के लिए करेंगे. फिर सेकेंड और थर्ड डिकेड ऑफ लाइफ में वी शुड थिंक अबाउट द पैनक्रियाटिक एंड द ब्रेस्ट कैंसर. ठीक है, देर आर सो मेनी अदर कैंसर एज वेल, लेकिन आप लोग ये जो इम्पोर्टेंट कैंसर है यू शुड मेमोराइज दैट द सेक्स फॉर ट्यूमर्स वी शुड सर्विलेंस, वी शुड डू अ मॉनिटरिंग और वी शुड डू स्क्रीनिंग एट बर्थ फॉर द सेक्स फॉर ट्यूमर्स ऑफ द टेस्टिंग. देन what will happen similarly in this Peutz-Jeghers polyps in polyps and syndrome, patient also have the mutation, that is loss of function mutation in the STK11 gene. Okay, STK11 gene is the tumor suppressor gene, right? So and I think you all know about it, that what is the gain of function mutation and there is loss of function. ठीक है, both are hazardous to our body. ठीक है ना, if there is gene function, if there is increase, it means if mutation occurs and then that gene function is increased, then what will happen? There may be the patient can be prone or can prone to the several malignancies. While if the patient has a loss of function mutation, then patient at that time also prone to develop the malignancy. Okay, so both are hazardous to our body. Okay. Achha, one thing I want to discuss about that, the Peutz-Jeghers syndrome, the morphology of the Peutz-Jeghers syndrome is overlap with the sporadic hematometastasis. ठीक है, तो अब हम लोग क्या करेंगे कि दोनों की हमने फर्स्ट करेंगे, if we see the slides and both are similar, more or less similar, then what will happen? Then obviously we will go for the detection of the mutation. That's why the mutation is very important. Is a diagnostic criteria to see either this mutation is present or not. If the STK11 mutation is present, so you should think about the Peutz-Jeghers polyp syndrome. ठीक है, and it is very helpful diagnostically. ठीक है, in patient with the polyp who has also the hyperpigmentation. अच्छा, Peutz-Jeghers polyp mostly present in the small intestine, but may also occur in the stomach, colon, bladder, and lung. Grossly, the polyps are large and pedunculated with a lobulated contour. And histologically, it characterizes the arborizing network of the connective tissues, smooth muscle cells, lamina propria, and the gland lined by the normal appearing intestinal epithelium. Here you can see the smooth muscles. How much smooth muscle bundles are present over here? If you compare it with the juvenile polyp. In juvenile polyp, there are no smooth muscles. So many smooth muscles. Here, you can see there are so much smooth muscles are present over here. Right? Similarly, there is a complex glandular architecture. Okay? These are all glands and these are complex glands. Okay? Complex glands. And these are the features that distinguish it from the Peutz-Jeghers polyp syndrome from the juvenile polyp. Are you getting better? It means that in the Peutz-Jeghers there is a complex glandular structure. Okay, there is a smooth muscle proliferation. Why? In the juvenile polyp, there is no smooth muscle proliferation. Okay. Now come on the neoplastic polyp. Any neoplastic mass lesions in the TIP may produce mucosal protrusions on polyps. This include adenocarcinoma, neuroendocrine tumors, stromal tumors, metastatic cancers from the distant site, and the most common is the colonic adenoma. Okay, so here we will discuss the colonic adenoma. The adenomas are intraepithelial neoplasms that range from the small, often pedunculated polyp to a large, cystic lesions. Okay, pedunculated जो होंगे वो बेटा mostly small size होता है. Sessile jo honge become larger ho jayenge, it means the stalk is absent over there and then largely grow on the surface. Theek hai, so there is a small male predominance and they are present in approximately 30% of the adults living in the western world by age 60. Colorectal adenomas are characterized by presence of the epithelial dysplasia. Acha, what is dysplasia? It means there is a disordered growth of the cells. Theek hai, so most adenomas are silent except large polyps that produce occult blood. So occult blood kya hota hai? Please write down in your chat box what is occult blood. Very good. Hidden blood. Theek hai. Very good. Not can't be grossly seen or can't be seen by the naked eye and the patient is complaining of the black spot. ठीक है बेटा, सो ऑकल ब्लड में क्या होता है कि पेशेंट मोस्टली गिव द कंप्लेन ऑफ द ब्लैक स्टूल. ठीक है, सो इफ द पेशेंट कम विद द ब्लैक स्टूल, यू शुड थिंक अबाउट द ऑकल ब्लड. सो मोस्टली वी राइट द स्टूल वी आर विद द ऑकल ब्लड. ठीक है, हम लोग इस तरह से मोस्टली के ऑकल ब्लड करते, तो इसमें भी क्या होगा कि ऑकल ब्लड होगा. ठीक है, फ्रेश ब्लड नहीं होगा। अच्छा, फ्रेश ब्लड की तो और भी बहुत सारे कॉजेस होते हैं ना, मोस्ट कॉमन इज द हेमरॉइड्स है, ठीक है ना, जिसमें जो है फ्रेश ब्लड आता है पेशेंट को, या फिशर्स होते हैं उसमें फ्रेश ब्लड की स्ट्रीक होती है, या फिर डिसेंट्री होती है उसमें फ्रेश ब्लड होता है, ठीक है। लेकिन इसमें अगर हम कोलोनिक एडिनोमा में देखें, रेक्टल ब्लीडिंग बेटा एडिनोकार्सिनोमा में रेक्टल ब्लीडिंग होती है, ठीक है, उसमें आपको फ्रेश ब्लड मिलेगा, लेकिन इसमें क्या होगा, ऑकल ब्लड होगा। सो इफ देयर इज ऑकल ब्लड यू शुड थिंक अबाउट द कोलोनिक एडिनोमा। And because these polyps are precursors to the colorectal adenocarcinoma, so it is recommended that all adults undergo surveillance by the age of the 50 years. Okay, mostly in the Western countries. Okay, patient at increased risk, including family history. It should be screened at least 10 years before the youngest age at which relative was dying. Are you getting this point? Those patients who are increased risk. Achha, who are those patients who are at increased risk? Which have the positive family history. Okay? If the patient has a positive family history, they should be screened at least 4 years, at least 10 years before the youngest age. It means that the family history is at the age of the 50 years, then the patient, suspected patient, should be screened at the age of the 40 years. The colonoscopy is the most common method, and adenoma are, although the adenoma are less common in the Asia, but now it is, its frequency is increasing because of the lifestyle, because of the processed meat, because of the red meat intake, less fiber intake. Okay, so ab ye jo hai Asia mein bhi increase ho raha hai sense. And the now come on the classification of the adenoma. Tubular, ठीक है, ये histopathologically इसको classify किया गया है कि if it is tubular. Tubular means tubular glands are present. ठीक है, small pedunculated polyps composed of the round or tubular gland. So it means it is tubular. Then villous adenoma, it means there are villi are present. ठीक है, which are often large and the sessile. Then tubulovillus kya honge? Have a mixture of the tubular and the villus. Yani tubular glands are also present and villi are also present. Then sessile serrated adenomas. Malignant potential hota hai inka, theek hai? But sessile serrated adenomas, they have typical cytological features of dysplasia that are present in other adenomas. Theek hai, jo typical features hote hain dysplasia ke, to wo sessile serrated adenomas mein nahi honge. Theek hai? But they have the malignant potential. Here you can see this is a pedunculated adenoma. Okay? It means there is a stalk and this is a pedunculated adenoma. Right? Here you can see the smooth surface and the rounded glands. These are all glands. These are smooth surface. But here you can see this is how much crepes are dilated. These crepes are dilated. Right? In case of the colonic adenoma, here you can see villous adenoma. A villous, ये tubular adenoma से है जिसमें glands थे ना ज़्यादा, ठीक है, glands enlarge हो गए थे. अच्छा, now come on the villous adenoma. Villous adenoma with the long cylinder like villi. ठीक है, these are all villi. We all know about it. ठीक है, villi long cylinder projections that are reminiscent of the small intestinal villi. Then come on the dysplastic epithelial cell. Here you can see the nuclear cytoplasmic ratio is increased, right? Kitna zyada isme nucleus ka size increase ho chuka hai. Theek hai? So this is the dysplastic cells, dysplastic epithelial cells and nuclear pseudo stratification. Then this is the sessile, as I have discussed, sessile means sawtooth appearance. This is the cut surface of the crypts, and here you can see goblet cells. Without sessile serrated adenoma lined by the goblet cells. These are all goblet cells, small white cells. These are all goblet cells without cytological features of dysplasia. अच्छा, इसमें क्या है जो sessile serrated है, इसमें dysplastic नहीं है. आप इसमें देख सकते हो, इससे अगर compare करो, इसमें dysplastic changes नहीं, dysplastic changes are present over here. But in case of the sessile serrated adenoma, there is no dysplastic changes are present. ठीक है? Now come on prevention. We have discussed the regular surveillance, colonoscopy, and polyp removal reduces the incidence of the colorectal adenocarcinoma. Risk of malignancy pe aa jao to 40% of the lesions, if larger than 4 cm in diameter, contains a variety of cancers. And high-grade dysplasia is also a risk factor for cancer in an individual polyp. So you can see the size is very much important. If its size is more than 4 centimeters, then there is a 40% greater risk to develop the malignancy. Now come on the FAP or familial adenomatous polyposis. This is autosomal dominant disorder and 75% cases are inherited. Patient can develop numerous colorectal adenomas as a teenager. Okay? Achha, mostly mutations occur in the APC gene or adenomatous polyposis coli. Achha, what is APC gene? APC gene are the negative regulator of the Wnt signaling pathway. Okay? This is the tumor suppressor gene, the APC gene. So this pathway, achha, Wnt signaling pathway kya hota hai? Wnt signaling pathway is involved in the control of gene expression. Some polyposis, okay, gene expression ko control karta hai. If there is a mutation, then what will mean? There is a overexpression of the gene. Okay? Or as I have already told you, there is always hazardous if there is a loss of function or there is a gain of function mutation in the gene. Okay? Achha. Apart from the mutation in the APC gene, there is a chance of the biallelic mutation of the base excision repair genes. Okay? This gene is called MYH, also referred to as the MUTYH. Okay? This is autosomal recessive disorder and this term is MYH associated polyposis. Achha, base excision repair gene kya hota hai? Any idea? What is base excision repair? It repairs the damaged DNA throughout the cell cycle. Obviously, if there is a mutation, then what will happen? DNA will not be repaired and ultimately patient may develop the polyps or malignancy. अच्छा अब एफ ए पी के लिए क्या चीज जरूरी है वॉट इज मैंडेटरी एटलीस्ट 100 पॉलिप्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द क्लासिक एफ ए पी अगर 1 to 2 पॉलिप्स हैं तो यू शुड नॉट थिंक अबाउट द एफ ए पी ठीक है कोलोरेक्टल एडेनोकार्सिनोमा डेवलप इन 100% ऑफ अनट्रीटेड एफ ए पी पेशेंट ऑफन बिफोर एज 30 एंड नियरली ऑलवेज बाई एज 50 सो प्रोफाइलेक्टिक कोलेक्टिमी इज द स्टैंडर्ड थेरेपी फॉर द इंडिविजुअल्स carrying APC mutation. Colectomy prevents the colorectal cancer. Familial adenomatous polyposis में अब आप देखो बेटा how much polyps are present in this gene. देखो. Sorry. Hundreds of small polyps are present throughout this colon. And these are the three tubular adenomas are present in this single microscopic field. This is a single microscopic field and here you can see three tubular adenomas. This one, tubular adenomas, how much glands are present over there, right? Second and third. So three tubular adenomas are present. So this is a familial adenomatous polyposis histopathology. Now come on the hereditary non-polyposis colorectal cancer. Hereditary non-polyposis polyrectal cancer, also known as Wnt syndrome, HPNCC is caused by inherited mutation in the genes that encode the protein responsible for detection, excision, and repair of the error that occurred during the DNA replication. It means same thing as I have previously discussed that if there is a mutation, inherited mutation, that is germline mutation. Okay? Present that protein which causes the detection, excision, and repair of the error. Ultimately, what will happen? Patient again can develop the cancer. Familial clustering of the cancer to the several sites, including colorectum, endometrium, stomach, ovary, ureter, brain, small bowel, hepatobiliary tract, pancreas, and it accounts for 2 to 4% of all colorectal cancer, and making it the most common syndrome form of the cancer. Mostly occur in the younger ages and are often located in the right colon. Now come on the adenocarcinoma. Adenocarcinoma of the colon is the most common malignancy of the GIP and is a major cause of morbidity and mortality worldwide. The dietary factor is mostly associated with an increased colorectal cancer. Achha, beta, any idea why increased fiber diet prevents the colorectal cancer or adenocarcinoma? Any idea? Please write down why decreased fibrous diet those who are on a low intake of unabsorbable vegetable fibers are more prone to develop the adenocarcinoma. So why constipation causes, why, then what will happen? If there is no improved bowel movement, then what will happen? ये बताओ मुझे. Why, if the patient has no constipation, okay, then what will happen? चलो मैं बताती. देखो व्हाट विल हैपन, रिड्यूस फाइबर लीड टू डिक्रीज स्टूल पर. ओके इट्स ओके, यू हैव रिटन वेरी गुड. एंड ऑल्टर्ड कंपोजिशन ऑफ द इंटेस्टिनल माइक्रोबायोटा. ठीक है, से नो बेटा दिस इज नॉट आईलियस. आईलियस क्या होता है? इफ वी आर नॉट टेकिंग द इनफ फाइबर देन वी कैन डिवेलप आईलियस. नो, आईलियस इज समथिंग एल्स, यू आर कंफ्यूजिंग इट विद इट. चलो अब सुनो कि मैं क्या कह रही हूँ. अच्छा, व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन देयर इज अ डिक्रीज स्टूल बल्क एंड ऑल्टर्ड कंपोजिशन ऑफ द इंटेस्टिनल माइक्रोबायोटा. व्हाट विल हैपन, दिस चेंज में इंक्रीज द सिंथेसिस ऑफ द टॉक्सिक ऑक्सीडेटिव बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द बैक्टीरियल मेटाबॉलिज्म. ठीक है, विच रिमेन इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द म्यूकोजा एंड इट मे कन्वर्ट इन टू द कार्सिनोजन. समझ में आई बात? What will happen if there is the or obviously when there is a decreased stool bulk? ठीक है, तो it will obviously alter the composition of the intestinal microbiota. ठीक है, then क्या होगा? जब बहुत सारे bacteria will gather in the intestine, obviously there will be a production of the oxidative products. Toxic metabolism will start to occur. And then ultimately, obviously, when their byproducts will in contact with the mucosa of the intestine, and ultimately it will cause the changes in the epithelial lining of the intestine. And these byproducts of the bacterial metabolism are carcinogens, right? देखो बेटा क्या होता है कि altered composition of the Muhammad. मोहम्मद शाह क्या? अच्छा, इन्होंने मुझसे दोबारा से पूछा है. देखो बेटा क्या होता है कि इफ द डाइट इज देयर आर नॉर्मल फ्लोराज आर प्रेजेंट इन अवर इंटेस्टाइन. ठीक है, बेटा आर यू लिसनिंग? Can you hear me? Okay. Then what will happen when there is an altered composition? When there is an altered composition of the intestinal microbiota, it will increase the synthesis of the toxic metabolites. ठीक है, bacterial metabolism से क्या होगा कि toxic metabolites का synthesis increase हो जाएगा. And ultimately, जब उसका साइड में जब product ठीक है, when there is a byproduct, increase oxidative toxic byproduct will produce and ultimately it will causes the you can say that byproduct will come across with the mucosal lining of the intestine and these byproducts are the carcinogens. ठीक है, so this is the main reason okay, why the fibrous diet is very necessary for our fibrous diet. नहीं ले रहे, we are not taking fibrous diet and even Pakistanis our lifestyles are not good. Yes, so much and that's why we are more prone to develop the adenocarcinoma. यहाँ पे तुम लोग सिविल हॉस्पिटल में जब जाओगे उधर के वार्ड तुम देखोगे डॉक्टर अमजद सिराज का जो वार्ड है उसमें आप देख सकते हो कि इतने यंग पेशेंट 16-17 ईयर्स के जो पेशेंट्स होते हैं they have developed the adenocarcinoma. ठीक है। ओके अच्छा, पैथोजेनेसिस में मैं ज्यादा डिटेल में नहीं जाऊंगी। इसमें देयर आर टू डिस्टिंक्ट पाथवेज, एपीसी बीटा कैटेनिन पाथवेज होता है, ठीक है। इसमें ऑब्वियसली दिस इज द ट्यूमर सप्रेसर जीन एंड मिसमैच रिपेयर पाथवे, ठीक है। बोथ पाथवे इन्वॉल्व इन द एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ द मल्टीपल म्यूटेशन एंड अल्टीमेटली इट विल कॉज द एडिनो, इट विल कॉज द एडिनो कार्सिनोमा, ठीक है। एडिनो कार्सिनोमा आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अक्रॉस extend along the bulb wall of the large caliber cecum and ascending colon, and these tumor rarely cause obstruction. Okay, acha, what is exophytic? Exophytic mean tends to grow outward beyond the surface epithelium. Theek hai? Okay, exophytic means, what is the meaning of exophytes? Exophytic means tends to grow outside. ठीक है, exophytic means tends to grow outside beyond the surface epithelium, right? And if the tumor present in the proximal colon, it is polypoid, it is exophytic, that extend along the bulb wall of the large caliber cecum and ascending colon, and these tumor rarely cause obstruction. ठीक है? While if the carcinoma is present in the distal colon, it tends to be annular lesion. Annular का क्या मतलब होता है? It surrounds the intestine. ठीक है? If it surrounds the intestine, it appears like a napkin ring constriction. अच्छा, napkin rings आप लोगों ने देखी है बेटा? Napkin ring constriction, or you can say the apical core constrictions हो जाती है इसमें. ठीक है? And it causes the luminal narrowing, and patient can go into the intestinal obstruction. ठीक है, इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट इफ द पेशेंट इफ द ट्यूमर इज प्रेजेंट इन द प्रॉक्सिमल कोलन देन इट विल नॉट कॉज द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, व्हाइल इफ इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द डिस्टल कोलन पेशेंट कैन डेवलप द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. हाउ? बिकॉज इट टेंड्स टू बी एन्युलर लीजन. एन्युलर मीन इट सराउंड्स द इंटेस्टाइन. ठीक है, तो जो नेपकिन रिंग लाइक अपीयरेंस हो जाती है, नेपकिन रिंग कॉन्स्ट्रक्शन भी कहते हैं इसको. और सेकंड थिंग इज इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज द एपिकल कोर अपीयरेंस. ठीक है, हियर यू कैन सी कोलोरेक्टल कार्सिनोमा सर्कमफेरेंशियल. ये देखो, ये सर्कमफेरेंशियल है, होल सर्कमफेरेंस इज इन्वॉल्व ऑफ द सीकम. ये देखो, ये सीकम था, इसका पूरा सॉरी रेक्टम है ये, और इसका ये होल सर्कमफेरेंस इज इन्वॉल्व. ठीक है, सर्कमफेरेंशियल अल्सरेटेड रेक्टल कैंसर. एंड हियर यू कैन सी द कैंसर ऑफ द सिग्मोइड कोलन दैट हैज इन्वेडेड थ्रू द मस्कुलरिस प्रोप्रिया एंड इज प्रेजेंट विद द सब सीरोसल एडिपोस टिश्यूज. ये ठीक है, एंड दिस इज द चॉकी नेक्रोसिस आर प्रेजेंट विद इन द कोलोनिक वॉल. Now come on the histologic appearance of the colorectal carcinoma. Well differentiated adenocarcinoma hai. Achha, what is the difference? What is well differentiated carcinoma? What is meant by well differentiated? Please write down what is well differentiated. This is well differentiated carcinoma. Note that elongated hyperchromatic nuclei. These are all elongated hyperchromatic nuclei and necrotic debris present in the gland. देखो ये glands थे, इसमें तुम देखो कि necrotic debris are also present over here. ठीक है, एंड दिस इज द पुअरली डिफरेंशिएटेड. दिस इज वेल डिफरेंशिएटेड व्हाइल दिस इज पुअरली डिफरेंशिएटेड एडिनोकार्सिनोमा फॉर्म्स अ फ्यू ग्लैंड्स बट इज लार्जली कंपोज्ड ऑफ इन्फिल्ट्रेटिंग नेस्ट ऑफ द ट्यूमर सेल्स. ठीक है बेटा, दिस इज वेल डिफरेंशिएटेड, दिस इज पुअरली डिफरेंशिएटेड. Very good. Well differentiated means सिमिलर टू द नॉर्मल टिश्यू इन अपियरेंस. एग्जैक्टली ठीक है, यानी कि इफ इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द रेक्टम, तो जो रेक्टम की जो लाइनिंग होगी, जो रेक्टम के सेल्स होंगे, इट इज रियली रिसेम्बल्स टू दैट. ठीक है, इट मीन दिस इज वेल डिफरेंशिएटेड. एंड पुअरली डिफरेंशिएटेड मीन इट इज नॉट अलाइक द रेक्टम. ठीक है, दिस इज नॉट लाइक द रेक्टम. Now come on the clinical features. Fatigue and weakness due to iron deficiency anemia, right-sided colon. If there is a rectal bleeding, obviously patient can have the fatigue and weakness. Then occult bleeding, changes in the bowel habits or cramping. If there is the left lower quadrant discomfort, right? Now come on the staging. American AJCC TNM classification of colorectal carcinoma. बेटा दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ये हमेशा आप लोग के काम आएगी. यू शुड नो अबाउट दी TNM classification. T stands for tumor, N stands for lymph nodes, and M stands for metastasis. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ कम ऑन द ट्यूमर, दैट इज टी. अच्छा, टी आई एस, दैट इज ट्यूमर इन साइटू. वॉट इज ट्यूमर इन साइटू, एनी आइडिया? वॉट इज ट्यूमर इन साइटू? In situ dysplasia, what is the meaning of in situ? What is carcinoma in situ? Anyway, yes, no, basement membrane intact nahi. It means that basement, it will not invade the basement membrane. Theek hai? So carcinoma in situ means tumor will not invade the basement membrane. Theek hai? Here you can see in situ dysplasia. Here you can see it will is in situ or intramucosal carcinoma. If there is a intramucosal carcinoma, it means this is carcinoma in situ or TIS. While the T1 is the tumor invades the submucosa. Here you can see the tumor invades the submucosa. Then what is T2? If the tumor invade into but not through the muscularis propria, it will not. देखो ये muscularis propria है, but it will it just invade, it just enter into the muscularis propria but not invade. ठीक है, deeply. That is T3 classification. Then T3A is in T3 is tumor invade through the muscularis propria. Here it will just penetrate but not invade. Here it will wholly invade into the muscularis propria. So this is T3. T3 is further classified into T3A, B, C, D. अच्छा बेटा, this is all rectification. ना मैं इसको जल्दी-जल्दी go through बस करती
हूँ. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, time is over, ma'am. Please.
Time over हो गया?
जी ma'am, 3 बज रहे हैं.
नहीं, अभी तो 3 slide तो भाई late शुरू हुआ था ना?
नहीं नहीं.
नहीं, 2 बजे शुरू नहीं हुआ था, 2 के बाद शुरू हुआ है. दो पांच
मैम, 3 बजे ओवर ए पॉइंट चला आएगा मैम, प्लीज.
अच्छा, तो बस मैं जल्दी से ये गो थ्रू कर दूं. दो स्लाइड रह गई हैं.
जी
ओके बेटा. अच्छा, अब आप लोग इसका बेटा ये टोटल रेक्टिफिकेशन है, आप इसको देख लेना, इस क्लासिफिकेशन को. ठीक है, क्योंकि अब हम लोग का टाइम बिल्कुल खत्म हो रहा है. ओके, अब इस पे अब आप लोग आ जाएंगे. एजीसी क्लासिफिकेशन है, इसमें भी टीएनएन क्लासिफिकेशन होती है. वन जो होता है उसमें क्या होता है, T1 है, एन नॉट है और एम है, तो आप इसको स्टेज वन बोलोगे. टू ए में क्या होगा, अगर टी थ्री है, एन नॉट है, एम जीरो है, तो आप इसको स्टेज टू ए बोलोगे. ठीक है, तो दिस इज नॉट रॉकेट साइंस, इसको तुम लोग देख सकते हो खुद से भी. ओके, नाउ कम ऑन द मेटास्टेटिक कोलोरेक्टल कार्सिनोमा. हियर यू कैन सी द लिम्फ नोड इज इन्वॉल्व, हियर यू कैन सी द प्लूरा इज इन्वॉल्व और लंग इज इन्वॉल्व, एंड हियर यू कैन सी द लिवर इज इन्वॉल्व. This is the metastatic colorectal carcinoma. Now come on the carcinoid tumors. Carcinoid tumor arise from the diffuse component of the endocrine system and are now properly referred to the well differentiated neuroendocrine tumors. Most are often found in the GIT and more than 40% occur in the small intestine. Intact mucosa hota hai isme, and tumor infiltrating the submucosa. Solid nest of the monotonous population of the cell, small wrong nuclei, scan to the moderate granular cytoplasm. इसकी जो क्लिनिकल फीचर्स है, cutaneous flushing होगी, diarrhea, cramps, nausea, vomiting. क्योंकि बेटा इसमें क्या होता है कि न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स रिलीज होने शुरू हो जाते हैं, हॉर्मोन्स रिलीज होने शुरू हो जाते हैं, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंगली जो है वो सिम्टम्स क्लिनिकल फीचर्स डिवेलप होते हैं. ठीक है, कार्सिनॉइड ट्यूमर्स में ये होता है. अच्छा, प्रोग्नोसिस क्या है कि इट इज रिलेटेड टू द फोरगट, देन एसोफेगस, स्टमक, ड्यूडेनम, रेयरली मेटास्टेसाइज. फिर मिडगट में क्या होता है कि जेजुनम और इलियम होता है. वी ऑल नो मिडगट कंसिस्ट ऑफ जेजुनम एंड इलियम, सो दिस इज मोर अग्रेसिव. अग्रेसिव क्यों होता है? बिकॉज ये आपका डिफरेंट प्लेसेस पे जाके इन्वेड करता है. ठीक है, दैट्स वाई दिस इज मोर अग्रेसिव. देन हाइंडगट होता है, हाइंडगट में रेक्टल कार्सिनोइड प्रोड्यूस पॉलीपेप्टाइड हॉर्मोन्स एंड मे बी सिम्टोमेटिक, मोस्टली इंसिडेंटल फाइंडिंग. अच्छा, गिस्ट क्या है? द मेजोरिटी ऑफ द नॉन एपिथेलियल ट्यूमर है, यानी दिस इज अ मेसेनकाइमल ट्यूमर है. ठीक है, ट्यूमर शो स्मूथ मसल और न्यूरल डिफरेंशिएशन और कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बोथ और मेल एंड डिफरेंशिएशन. इसका ओरिजिन क्या है? इंटरस्टीशियल सेल ऑफ कैजल. बिहेवियर बेनाइन और मेलेग्नेंट दोनों हो सकते हैं, एंड इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द साइज, माइटोसिस, न्यूक्लियस, न्यूमोटिक. एंड मोस्ट गिस्ट हैव अ सोमेटिक म्यूटेशन इन द सीकेट जीन. ठीक है, एनी क्वेश्चन बेटा? I think it's okay. I think you have understand. If you have any question.
मैम कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं आ रहा अभी तक.
हाँ, कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं आया, एक ने थैंक्स बोल दिया. ओके बेटा, ओके, चलो बस ठीक है. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू मैडम.